And it also needs to be told, the users need to be told or informed whether there is a separation of the prohibited earnings and expenditure. It's disclosed, and they have to be informed what has been done with this prohibited earnings, especially whether they have been cleansed or not. And then the economic information, these are more in line with the conventional accounting. In addition to all this, you also need information to assist the concerned party in the determination of zakah on the Islamic Bank's fund and the purpose for which it will be disbursed. Now, as you know that not all banks, Islamic banks, collect and distribute zakat. This is allowed by OFI because, as you know, Islamic banks are not natural persons. They are corporate bodies, artificial corporations. Therefore, there is no sharia to enforce banks to pay zakat on the income. However, the people who own the banks, the shareholders and the depositors who make income out of their funds investment, they have to pay zakat on their shareholdings or their investments. Now, for that purpose, they need information on how much zakat should they pay for each dollar of investment or share they hold. Now, some countries, some Islamic banks, they actually take the zakat due by the bank and distribute it themselves. Some countries, like in Malaysia, the banks just give their zakat to the Islamic religious councils because they are mandated by the law of the country to collect and distribute the zakat. Some in some countries like Indonesia, they give them to the NGO bodies which collect and distribute zakat. Okay, so the type of zakat reports will depend on whether the bank collects and distributes zakat. In that case, it will be a bit more complex report. Okay, or they just show the amount of zakat paid to the relevant authorities, or they just tell them, disclose how much zakat is payable for dollar of share. And in some, I think, for example, Bahrain Islamic Bank, we see, I think I'll show you later, they will show a statement on how they calculate the zakat. Okay? So those people who want to do a little bit of auditing by themselves can do, you know, whether the bank has calculated the zakat properly or not. Okay? FPI information to assist in estimating cash flow. This is a conventional requirement which is also required in Islamic accounting because, alright? And then the G is information to assist in evaluating Islamic banks, discharge of its fiduciary responsibility to safeguard funds and invest them at reasonable rates of return. Please pay attention to reasonable rates of return as opposed to maximum rate of return. Okay, and also need to disclose information about investment rate of return on banks' investment as opposed to investment account holders' investments. Okay, and of course, finally, the information about the Islamic bank's discharge of its social responsibilities. These are the information required by Muslim users. So, AOF has recommended a set of financial statements. If you look at this figure here, there are actually seven statements. These four on the left, statement of financial position, which is balance sheet, income statement, cash flow, and retained earnings. These are conventional financial statements. The additional Islamic ones are statement of sources and uses of funds, restricted investment account changes, as well as source and uses of zakah and khar. Khard is here and zakat and charity is here. Now, this one, I think this standard came out, I think, about 20 years back. And they have not revised the standard. So, I think it's about time, since we have issued a standard on social disclosure, social responsibility disclosure. It's about time to come out with the standard on the other reports like social responsibility report, audit reports, and also they also should separate this statement. They mix the zakah and charity together. But as we know, sadaqah or charity is voluntary, and whereas zakat is specific to certain asnaf, and therefore we should separate the funds and we shouldn't mix them together, because otherwise we won't know how much of zakat we have paid to the asnaf. So they need to revise their annual reports, but at least there are some which is in addition to the conventional one. Now, what we are going to do next is to see some examples of annual reports. Okay? We will start with the annual report of a conventional bank to see how a conventional bank looks like. And then we go on to Islamic banks who do not follow AOP. Although Malaysia is an Islamic finance hub, unfortunately it doesn't follow Islamic accounting standards because of the pressures from IASB, and the accounting profession here. But like if you take the case of Bahrain, for example, we can get accounting statements which are more online at the AOP. Alright? So let's look at, so we will take the AOP standards as a proxy for Islamic accounting standards, which they are, but they are not very comprehensive yet. Alright? So if banks follow AOP, then they would be Islamic. If they don't, then you will see the consequences. Let's look at the conventional bank first. We are just going to look at two sets of accounts. One is the balance sheet or statement of financial position, and the other one is income statement. When they change this to a high resolution one, I think we lost this thing. Was, I just made it very big just now. Don't know whether. Let me see whether I can increase the view. Okay. Oh, it's getting blurred because the more you increase, let's see. Okay. Let's look at this. I hope you can see something. This is an example of a conventional bank balance sheet. And we can see the assets and liabilities and equity. So we have basically, as you know, banks deal with, investments. So they have cash and securities and deposits and placement and others, and different type of securities held for trading and sale. But the biggest item in their balance sheet is loans and advances, because they provide financing to customers based on interest. Alright? And they have statutory deposits with the central bank, and they have, of course, plant, property and equipment. These are not very big items. So as you can see, the biggest items in a bank balance sheet, the assets are the loans and advances as well as the investment in securities. Now if you look at the liability we have on the other side, deposits from your customers. Okay. Chagamas here is actually the mortgage institutions, okay, which securitize the loans. Alright. And then we have the shareholders' equity. Nothing much. And let's look at the income statement now. I think you can see this. Alright. So here we have interest income. Remember, this is a conventional bank, yeah? So interest income. I hope you can see this here. 1.66 billion, and they have interest expense. So you got a net interest income, other operating income. You add, you get 1.3 billion, and after the operating expenses, okay, you get an operating profit, and then you provide allowance for bad and doubtful loan losses, and then you have a net income, and you pay your tax, and this is the actual net profit for the shareholders. Okay, so this is a normal conventional account, the income statement and balance sheet. Now let's look at so we have seen a conventional income and statement and balance sheet. Now we are going to look at Islamic banks But they do not follow AOP, they just follow IFRS or the National Accounting Standards. So let's look at this. Can you see that? Okay. Let me make it again view. Okay, I think you can see this one. Okay, this is an Islamic bank, yeah? Alright. Let's look at which bank it is. This is Al Raji, okay? Al Raji is from Saudi. But this is Malaysian one, okay? Incorporated in Malaysia. So here we have cash and short-term funds, financing and advances, alright? And securities, alright? Now, if you look at the liability side, you have deposits from customers. So there is hardly any difference. Now, Al Raji follows, if you can call it, the Middle East Sharia, but unfortunately, when they operate in Malaysia, they have to follow the Malaysian accounting standards, which are basically a copy of the International Financial Reporting Standards. And therefore, this is what they get if they follow, okay? You hardly see anything, but in the notes to the accounts, I'm sorry I didn't bring it here. If you look at financing advances, the note 3, you will find a classification of the financing by contracts, whether it is Murabaha, Musharaka, that's the only information they give. Now let's look at the income statement. This is different from the conventional bank. We saw just now we had interest income and interest expense. Of course, in Islamic bank, we don't have that. So we start from income derived from investment in deposits funds. Okay, and then income derived from investment of shareholders funds. Then allowance for losses on financing. Distributable income, less income attributable to depositors. So this is the Rabul Mal share, 104 here. And this is the Mudarib share, 132. Okay? Plus your own income. Okay? And you deduct the expenses. Here you have Zakah. I think they stopped paying Zakah. Okay? I think... Now, Middle Eastern Bank, they don't pay Zakah on their own. They just inform the shareholder how much zakat they should pay per share. Alright? But in the Malaysian banks, you will find that because they follow the Saudi rules, okay? Their headquarters Sharia board, therefore they don't have zakat here. But in Malaysia, any zakat should be calculated and paid to the Malaysian religious council, which all the Malaysian Islamic banks, they do that. So they'll see some zakat here. Okay. Okay. The other thing you see in the balance sheet is this is the next one. Let's not confuse ourselves here. Let's go back to this. So, what I want to show you here is that whether Islamic banks or conventional banks, if you follow the conventional accounting standards, there's hardly any difference in the information which I listed down, which was given by UFA just now, is not there for us to use. Therefore, how can as Muslim users of accounts of Islamic banks get information which will allow us to do hisaba on ourselves, okay, and muhasaba on ourselves to see whether we are investing in the right bank or we are using the right bank, and whether the bank is doing what it's supposed to be doing to achieve social justice or socio-economic justice. So from this sort of annual report, we can't do anything because they just follow the conventional financial standards, accounting standards. Now let's look at an AOF-based balance sheet and income statement. Here, I think this is this one is, I think, Al Bahrain Bank. Yeah, Bahrain Islamic Bank. Of course, all Islamic banks in Bahrain have to follow the AOF standards. So if you look at this, you can instantly see the difference. Okay? If you follow Islamic accounting standards, you will see the information which we get is quite different.